Hey everyone, hope you're doing well today. Sorry if I sound a little weird, I'm still recovering from being sick, but today we're making an Alpha Arbutin Brightening Moisturizer. I know that label says cream, but I don't think it's quite thick enough to call it a cream, but moisturizer was too long to fit on the label, so I put cream on it. So this is a brightening moisturizer, meaning it can help fade dark spots and even out your skin tone. So I think a misconception about lightening or like brightening products is that they'll lighten your natural skin tone. They don't do that. They just help even out your skin tone and lighten spots that darken, you know, from like sunspots and stuff like that. So here is the formulation for this moisturizer. If you didn't know, if you're new to formulating, formulations are written in percents, and then you use the formula to create your recipe. So for this video, I'm making a 200 gram batch, which is our batch size, and this is the recipe I'm going to be using. If you want more information on this topic, I'll link my video down below that explains to you how to transfer formulations into a recipe. So let's get started. I'm starting with phase A, and I've already weighed out 108.4 grams of distilled water in this beaker. Then I'm going to add in some glycerin. This is a humectant. It helps hydrate the skin. It's wonderful for all skin types. I added in 10 grams of it. This is just a staple for basically every product. Then I'm going to be adding in some sodium phytates. So sodium phytate is a chelating agent. This can actually help boost the preservative, so it can actually, you know, keep your product fresher longer, and it can actually do a number of other things. What I actually recommend doing is, what I'm going to do is link down below to where you can buy sodium phytate, and you can read all about what it does, because it's way too long to explain in this video. But I added in 0.2 grams of it. This also helps raise the pH, which is the reason why I decided to use it as well. So mix that in until it dissolves. Put that to the side, and that's it for phase A. So now we're going to work on phase B, which I already weighed out 10 grams of Montanove 68 MB, which is our emulsifier. This is what's going to blend the oil and the water together and create like a creamy consistency for the moisturizer. Then I'm going to add in some cetyl alcohol. This will also help thicken up the moisturizer. This is an emollient. It helps hydrate the skin, and it also helps stabilize the emulsion. And I added in 4 grams of it. Then I'm adding in some rosehip seed oil. I love rosehip seed oil. It has vitamin A in it, which vitamin A is retinol, so this is anti-aging, and it's lightweight. It absorbs into the skin quickly, and I added in 20 grams of the rosehip seed oil. Then I'm adding in some papaya oil. This is said to help firm the skin and even out skin tone. It also helps moisturize the skin as well. And I added in 10 grams of it. And that's it for phase B. So what we're going to do next is we're going to take both phases and, well, actually, sorry. First, what you want to do is weigh your phase A, the total weight, including the beaker and everything. You want to take note of how much that weighs, because what we're going to do is cover both beakers with some foil, and we're going to be heating it up using a water bath. So since we're heating it up, some of the water might evaporate. So after we're done, we're going to have to weigh phase A again and replace any water that evaporates. So to make a water bath, just fill a pan with like an inch or so of water and place your beakers in and let them heat until everything in phase B melts, and make sure they're both around the same temperature. So while those are heating, I'm going to work on phase C. I added in 20 grams of distilled water, and this is simply being added in to help dissolve our powders. So the first powder I'm adding in is Alpha Arbutin, which is our active ingredient, and this is our lightening ingredient. This can help fade dark spots. It helps even out the skin tone. This is just one of the most popular ingredients to help lighten dark spots. And what I always recommend doing with powders is weighing them out separate, because they can be finicky to weigh out. So I grab this watch glass to weigh out 2 grams of the Alpha Arbutin. And then go ahead and pour the Alpha Arbutin into your distilled water. And then you can just mix it until the Arbutin dissolves. And it doesn't need to dissolve fully for you to go on to the next step, but it does dissolve pretty easily. So then I'm going to weigh out 6 grams of niacinmiade. This also can help lighten the skin. It's actually a really good ingredient to pair with Alpha Arbutin. It's also known as vitamin B3. Just wonderful for the skin, any skin type really. Can cause sensitivity at really high percentages though, so keep that in mind. Then I'm gonna add in some licorice root extract, which can also help lighten the skin. As you can see, we've got a common theme going on here. And I added in 4 grams of the licorice root extract. And then I'm gonna add in, honestly, I cannot pronounce this the actual name of this ingredient, but it is a peptide. And for short, we're gonna call it pea protein. So I'm adding in 4 grams of the pea protein. This can help condition, hydrate, and soothe the skin. So once everything's mixed together, as you can see, everything should be dissolved. And the last thing I'm gonna add into this is our preservative. I'm using 1 gram of liquid dermal plus. And then mixing it in. So face C also calls for vitamin E, but since this is oil soluble, I'm not gonna add it into the beaker we have here. Instead, I'm gonna add this directly into the moisturizer in the cool down phase later on, you'll see. So now that phase A and B are done being heated, I'm going to weigh phase A and replace any water that evaporated, about 1 gram evaporated. Then once that water is replaced, go ahead and pour phase A into phase B and then mix with your immersion blender. And you want to maybe come back and mix it periodically until it thickens up. Once it starts to thicken, you really don't have to mix it again after that. So once it cools to 100 degrees Fahrenheit or lower, you can add in the cool down ingredients. So I went ahead and added in all the cool down ingredients and mixed it in. And then I'm going to place the beaker on the scale, and now we're gonna add in the vitamin E. And I added in 0.4 grams of it. And then just mix that in. And now it's time to check and adjust the pH. So our two pH sensitive ingredients is the alpha arbutin and the niacinamide. Niacinamide needs to be in a pH of 6, and alpha arbutin can be anywhere between 3.5 to 6.6. So that means we need to go for a pH right around 6. It doesn't have to be exactly 6, but just roughly around it. The natural pH of this was right around 5, so that was too low. So we need to actually raise the pH. And we do this using, at least I like to do it, using a 10% sodium hydroxide solution. And I actually have a video all about how to adjust the pH, raise the pH, lower the pH, how to take the pH. It's a lot of information, so I'm not gonna cover it in this video, but I'll link that video down below so you guys can learn exactly how I'm raising the pH. I ended up adding in about 7 drops of the lye solution into this to raise the pH. So I added in a few drops of it, and then I mixed it into the moisturizer, and I let it sit for about a minute before I took the pH again. And I'm gonna place some of the cream into a small beaker again so I can take the pH again. And I got the pH to 5.81, which it's not exactly 6, but it's close enough. I was worried if I added in any more of the lye solution, I would make the pH too high, so I just stopped there. So once you've adjusted the pH, go ahead and cover your beaker and let your moisturizer sit overnight so it can reach its full viscosity. It will thicken up the next day. So if it's not thick enough now, just wait until the next day. And then you can jar up your moisturizer. I decided to use these amber jars because they were the only ones that had sanitized at the time, but none of these ingredients are light sensitive, so you can use a clear jar if you would like. And as you can see here, it's not super thick, but it's also not like thin enough to pump through a bottle or anything. So that's why I don't consider it a cream. It's not very, very thick. I think this moisturizer is the perfect consistency for really any skin type because it's not too heavy, but it's still moisturizing enough that you actually feel like your skin's being moisturized. It rubs into the skin super easily. There is no soaping effect. And another thing I wanted to mention that I forgot is the emulsifier I use, Montanove 60 MB, supposedly helps active ingredients better penetrate the skin. So that was another reason I decided to use that emulsifier. I also applied my labels to these jars. If you want to learn how to make labels, I'll link down below to my video that shows you guys how to do that. They are waterproof and they're oil proof. So I do hope you guys enjoyed this formulation. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. And let me know what other kind of brightening products you guys would like to see, because I get so many requests for brightening products. So I'll talk to you guys next time. Later.